Welcome back. It's week 22 and this week my camera stays in the bag since it's all about phone photography. Okay, so I want to start with a small confession. Phone photography doesn't give me nearly the amount of joy that my big mirrorless camera does. I'm not sure why, but it just feels like the tactile and the big clunky and all the settings and dials is a lot more pleasing and adds to the whole experience for me. Now don't get me wrong, it's not that I don't think there's great photos taken with phones, and there are some brilliant phone photographers out there. It's just for me, I prefer a much more tactile approach to photography. A lot like reading a book instead of on a tablet, or listening to vinyl instead of on a phone. Without stepping on anybody's toes or offending anybody, for me, I still see a reason we pay so much money for the camera bodies and their lenses. There is a superior quality to a camera photo instead of a phone photo, although probably just for the trained eye. But I understand 52Frames theme and challenge for this week, and the message they're trying to get out there. And that was purely that the equipment doesn't make a good photographer. A good photographer can take a photo with any equipment. And I respect that, because many times, if you've seen my previous video, I rely quite heavily on the technology that goes into my camera and lenses, which I pay for quite a bit. With all of that being said, the next big question was, where would I go with my phone, since I didn't have the limitation of only going to camera friendly locations? So somebody I know once made a comment and said something in the lines of, in a world where a library becomes redundant, Dubai goes and builds a 7-story library. Well, this redundant concept was my chosen location for this week's photo. Mohammed Bin Rashid Library, in short, MBRL. And although photography and video photography isn't completely banned in the library, the admin and paperwork going into that has always just been too much for me as a hobbyist photographer. Thus, this felt like the perfect opportunity to make use of this impressive building for this week's photo using only my phone. Thank you.
the season turns cold, I'd do it all again with you. Distant memories, or just a dream.
I hope that you noticed a few things. To start off, the architecture, which was inspired by a book laying open. The collaboration between students and colleagues. The availability of devices, iPads, laptops, MacBooks, screens, and so forth. Then the calming effect that the library had with elements like water on the sides. And then lastly, and probably my favorite part of the entire library, which I didn't videograph on that Saturday afternoon because it was quite busy, is the children's department. It's absolutely out of this world, bright colors with climbing castles and slides, reading tents and nooks. It's absolutely to dream about. Okay, but enough about me geeking out on this library. Let's go back to my photo. This week, I decided to take mobile photography even further. Not only am I shooting all of my footage on my iPhone as well for this week's photo, but I also decided to use my iPad to edit the photos on instead of my regular setup, which is a laptop and an extra monitor. I was amazed at the capabilities of the mobile version of Lightroom, and it worked especially well using the Apple Pencil. But I still prefer, obviously, the bigger screen of my laptop desktop setup, as well as Lightroom Classic's filing system works just a little bit better for me, so I'll probably stick to that, although I do now have that tool in my backpack that I know I'll use again. And for my mobile photos, that's probably gonna be a much better solution going forward, as everything syncs so well and I don't have SD cards and stuff like that. So I would definitely edit on my iPad again in the future. Okay, so I'm not going to stand here and pretend that I only ever take a photo with my big fancy camera, because that's really not the case. I use my phone so often because it's such a powerful camera which we are able to carry around in our back pocket. And like having books on our iPads and vinyl or records on our phone, all compact, is very convenient when I really want to enjoy the process. Dial down, slow down. I would prefer my clunky, oversized, heavy, many times unwelcome camera any day next to my camera because I like the process of it. And in my opinion, I do see a difference in quality. Well, I think my husband would say, well, I would hope so for that price. But any case, next week I'm back on my camera since I'm taking a photo of a song lyric, so I'll be listening to music a lot closer. Thank you for watching and see you then.